you still remember the first faces you saw when you were born? Or your first friends after moving to a new neighborhood and how you cried because you bruised your knee? Or your first puppy love and how your friends teased you all day about the flowers? You might not, but you might remember exactly how nervous and excited you felt, finally moving out of your house and going to college. Or how emotional did you become while looking at your pet cat that you saved that day on the street? What will you do if one day you wake up and find out that you had a near-death experience? That you came too close to death, even moving a millimeter would have made you lose your life. You might wake up running out of breath and desperately grasping for air, or like your heart is beating too fast, that you have started to have cold sweats. Either way, they said that when we come close to death, our brain allows us to briefly see our life in a matter of seconds or minutes. It was believed that after we die, our brain does not stop functioning immediately. It does its last task of flashing our life before our eyes. But when does our life really end? Is it when our heart stops beating? Or is it when our brain stops functioning? In today's episode of Science Curiosities, Science Times will dive deep into explaining what happens in the brain after a person has been pronounced clinically dead. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to always be notified of our next uploads. Researchers in a Canadian intensive care unit accidentally observed the brain activity of a patient pulled out of life support. The brain activity lasted for 7 minutes, making it seem that the dead were just in deep sleep or were only dreaming. After observing the activity of the cerebral cortex, or the part of the human brain in charge of higher level processes, including memory processing, it was found that the brain is capable of functioning before finally going to a complete stop. A healthcare writer divided this 7 minutes into how the brain sorts out a person's memories. The first minute allows the person to remember her very first memory after being born. The second minute is about the person's fondest childhood memories with friends. Then memories with one's closest partners are flashed. And then you remember parting with that person. For the last few minutes, one can recall the good deeds that he has done in his life. Is this possible? Well, experts have an explanation for that. Death occurs when the heart stops beating, stopping the supply of blood to all parts of our body. This eventually leads our brain to stop functioning and everything else. However, there always seems to be a lag. When the heart stops functioning, the brain can still process information. And experts say that we might even hear the doctor pronounce us dead. It sounds scary, so we cannot help asking why. A neurosurgeon states that this is because of brain oscillations, or waves, responsible for high cognitive functions like concentrating, dreaming, meditation, memory retrieval, information processing, and conscious perception. It was concluded that the consciousness of a person does not stop when the heart stops beating. The brain programs itself as if the host is in a deep sleep, dreaming about memories. Gamma waves, a type of brain wave that is the fastest, are produced in the first few minutes of clinical death. Before a complete drop of the person's consciousness, these gamma waves heighten, further making the clinically dead highly conscious. This wave allows that person to remember even his very first memories because of heightened consciousness. This will last a few minutes until the consciousness slowly drops to a zero. But why is a dying brain having a surge of waves that initiate heightened consciousness? According to research, this suggests a biological paradox, because the fastest brain waves are produced only when a brain is slowly dying because of lack of blood. A pulmonologist states that releasing this type of brain waves minutes before and after a clinical death suggests the concept of lucid consciousness, which allows people to gain consciousness for a little while. Until now, this is still one of the biggest mysteries of neuroscience, of why the brain releases gamma waves minutes before and after a person's heart stops beating. But according to a biomedical scientist, this is because this very act is part of the brain going into survival mode before entering a phase deprived of oxygen. This is also proven in animals experiencing brain death, where their organs begin to signal their brain to resurrect themselves by releasing a series of molecules. Even though external signs of consciousness are nowhere to be found, internal signs are active. This may also be because of what we call euphoric endorphins released in the hippocampus, a part of the brain responsible for processing and retrieving memories, due to the brain lacking oxygen to reduce stress inside the body. Or it may be because of the hormone noradrenaline, which is released by the part of the brain responsible for mediating memory and emotion, when the body is also stressed because of the lack of oxygen. Still, there is no definite explanation of why the brain delays stopping its functions, but a 7-minute brain activity after death is completely possible. Question is, does our life end when our hearts stop beating? Or is our brain still keeping us alive for a few minutes? If yes, can we really consider it a brief extension of our lives? If you want to know more, read the full article below. Also, subscribe to Science Times to be notified when we upload a new video. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up and check out our other videos in the Science Curiosity series.